गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू आवर चैप्टर फर्स्ट क्लासिक चैप्टर फर्स्ट एमर्जेंस एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर। इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट जनरेशन ऑफ द कंप्यूटर। स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो कंप्यूटर इज नॉट मेड अप इन ए वन डे, इन ए वन ईयर। दिस इज डेवलप्ड इन द डिफरेंट स्टेज। दिस स्टेज आर नोन एज जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर। अदर देन दिस वी हैव टू ऑल्सो डिस्कस about the types of computer. Analytical engine. Charles Babbage was a professor of mathematics in Cambridge University, England. In the year 1822, he designed and developed a machine known as difference engine. After working on the difference engine for 10 years, Babbage designed another machine named as analytical engine, which could perform the task based on its instructions. Students, Charles Babbage developed two machines. One was the difference engine and second was the analytical engine. But due to some reasons, the analytical development was not completely successful. But your modern computer depends on the working principle of analytical engine. That's why we regarded Charles Babbage as the father of computer. Lady Ada Agusta, she developed the concept of binary number system and applied in programming techniques. Hence, she is known as the first program of the universe. The computer language ADA Ada was named after her. Student, Lady Agusta was the first computer program and she developed Ada language that was used in the Charles Babbage machines also. Students, computer generation. First generation. As I have already told you earlier, computer was developed in the different stages and these stages are known as the computer generation. We have total 5 generations of the computer and each generation have some their special features. Now we are going to discuss about the first generation of computer. Features of this generation were, these computers were very large in size, occupying more space. Students, first computers of the first generation were very large, just like you can say a big room. Vacuum tubes were the only electronic component used in these computers. Student, the main component of the first generation computers was the vacuum tube. These computers were based on machine level language and assembly language. Student, machine language and assembly language were the main languages of these generation of computers. Disadvantages of first generation computers. These computers were difficult to operate. These computers needed heavy air conditioning system. These computers consumed huge power. Students, the first generation computers consumed more power. That's why these computers needed heavy air conditioning systems. Second generation computers. Students, in the first generation main component was the vacuum tube, but in the second generation vacuum tube was replaced with the transistors. Transistors were one of the main components used in the circuit. The processing speed increased from millisecond to microsecond. These computers required less power to run. Students, the scientists of that time were facing the problem in the first generation. They were trying to solve those problems. Mainly was the size. So that size was reduced in the second generation due to transistors. And when the size was reduced, that's why it consumed less power. Third generation computers. The features of third generation was IC technology, IC integrated circuit. technology make the size of computer still smaller. The cost of the computer reduced further. The capacity to hold data and information was more due to improved secondary storage devices. In the third generation students, the secondary storage devices were also used. That's why they have to increase their storage capacity. Fourth generation computers. The features of fourth generation computers were: these computers are for general purpose and widely used for commercial applications. Power consumption in these computers is very less. The language like SQL, C, C++, Java, etc. were developed in this generation. Fifth generation computers. The scientists are working to produce intelligent computers which can take decisions on their own. The main objective is to introduce genuine IQ in these computers so that they can think and behave like human beings. The main feature of this stage is also in the developing stage, which is not completely developed. In this, scientists are trying to increase the artificial intelligence in the computer system to increase their thinking skills and their IQ level. Classification of computer. A computer is basically classified in two ways, but in your class one is the also classification according to generation, but according to generation is the different matter. But mainly the computers are classified to two categories, based on purpose and based on their size. According to based on purpose computers, analog, digital and hybrid, and based on size, micro, mini, mainframe and super. Students, according to the purpose, computer can be divided into three categories: analog computer, digital computer and hybrid computer. Analog computer. It accepts any type of wave or signal which is continuously varying in nature. It always gives output as a pattern. For example, speedometer, clinical thermometer. Digital computer. It accepts constant input and displays an accurate result. Example, desktop computer and laptop computer. Hybrid computer. It is the digital computer that accepts analog signals, converts them to digital signals and processes them in digital form. For example, heartbeat measuring computer in hospital. Based on size of computer. According to the size, computers can be divided into four major categories: microcomputer, mini computer, mainframe computer and supercomputer. Microcomputer. Microcomputers are also known as personal computers. These are small in size and are widely used in offices and schools. Mini computer. Mini computers have high speed cache memory in addition to the main memory. Mainframe computer. Mainframe computers with huge storage capacity. These computers are generally used in large industries, banking, organizations and scientific research centers. Supercomputers. These computers have large memory. They can execute data and instructions faster other than any other computer. These computers are used in scientific, space research, weather forecasting, robotics, etc. Students, in this screen, you have to see all the main features of the different generations of the computer. These you have to write in your notebook and try to learn these, because these are the most important, and you can say this is the complete summary of your all types of generations of the computer. So this you have to write make a table and write this in your fair notebook. Exercise. First is state true or false for each of the following statements. First, generation means the advancement of technology in the computer. The time. According to time, yes, this is true. Second, Mark first was the first fully electronic computer. False. Students, Mark first was the not fully electronic. It was the electromechanical computer. Not was the fully electronic computer. That's why this is false. Third, first generation computers used machine level language to give data and instructions. Yes, students, in the first generation we have to use machine language and assembly language. This is true. The vacuum tubes replaced transistor. In the second generation computers, yes, students, in the first generation main component was the vacuum tube, but in the second generation vacuum tube replaced by the transistor. This is again true. 5. Fortran. सबसे पहले तो हमें Fortran का फुल फॉर्म पता होना चाहिए. दिस इज कॉल्ड फॉर्मूला ट्रांसलेटर. वॉज द फर्स्ट हाई लेवल लैंग्वेज डेवलप्ड इन द फर्स्ट जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. स्टूडेंट, Fortran वॉज ऑल्सो डेवलप्ड इन द फर्स्ट जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. दिस इज ट्रू. 6. एन इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट इज ए कॉम्पैक्ट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट पैक्ड इन ए सेमी कंडक्टर मटीरियल. Yes, this is true. Integrated circuit was packed in semiconductor material. 7. Personal computers, PC, were developed in fourth generation of computers. Yes, students, personal computers were developed in fourth generation. True. KIPS means kilobyte instructions per second. No, student, KIPS means knowledge information processing system होता है. ना कि किलोबाइट इंस्ट्रक्शन पर सेकेंड होता है. तो दिस इज फॉल्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेम द फॉलोइंग. फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रोमैकेनिकल कंप्यूटर. फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रोमैकेनिकल कंप्यूटर वॉज द मार्क फर्स्ट. क्वेश्चन सेकेंड, फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंप्यूटर ENIAC. ई फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक, एन फॉर न्यूमेरिक, I for integrated, A for automatic and C for calculator. Electronic, numeric, integrator and calculator. Student, A for AND है, यहाँ पे automatic नहीं है. Electronic, numerical, integrator and calculator. Next, name the main component used in. Question type next है. देखिए, first generation computers main component was the वैक्यूम ट्यूब. सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर मेन कंपोनेंट वॉज ट्रांजिस्टर. थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर मेन कंपोनेंट वॉज IC, इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट. फोर्थ जनरेशन कंप्यूटर मेन कंपोनेंट वॉज द माइक्रो प्रोसेसर. गिव टू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ईच. फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर ENIAC एंड EDVAC. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेटर एंड कैलकुलेटर ENIAC एंड EDVAC. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिस्ट्रक्टिव वेरिएबल ऑटोमेटिक कंप्यूटर कैलकुलेटर. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिस्ट्रिक्ट वेरिएबल ऑटोमेटिक कैलकुलेटर. सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर IBM 7070 एंड सेकेंड इज IBM 1400. थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर IBM 360 एंड हनीवेल 200. फोर्थ जनरेशन कंप्यूटर IBM 370 एंड इंटेल 4004. राइट डाउन द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ENIAC, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेटर एंड कैलकुलेटर. IBM, इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस मशीन एल एफ आई लार्ज स्केल इंटीग्रेशन एल आई पी एस लॉजिक इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग सिस्टम के आई पी एस नॉलेज इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग सिस्टम ई डी एफ ए सी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिले स्टोरेज ऑटोमेटिक कैलकुलेटर आई सी इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट कोबोल कॉमन बिजनेस ओरिएंटेड लैंग्वेज नेम द टू कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेजेस ऑफ फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर मशीन लैंग्वेज एंड असेंबली लैंग्वेज सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर कोबोल बेसिक थर्ड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर आरपीजी एंड एल्गोल ELGOL फोर्थ जनरेशन कंप्यूटर SQL C++ Define the following. Analog computer. It accepts any type of wave or signal which is continuously varying in nature. It always gives output as a pattern. For example, speedometer, clinical thermometer. Personal computer. Microcomputers are also known as personal computers. These are small in size and are widely used in offices and schools. Define the following. Digital computer. It accepts constant input and display an accurate result. For example, desktop computers and laptop computers. Supercomputer. These computers have large memory. They can execute data and instructions faster than any other computer. These computers are widely used in scientific, space research, weather forecasting, robotics, etc. Give three features of first generation computers. These computers were very large in size, occupying more space. Vacuum tubes were the only electronic component used in these computers. These computers were based on machine level language and assembly level language. Question 2. Give two limitations of first generation computers. These computers needed heavy air condition system. These computers consumed huge power. Give three features of second generation computer. Transistor were one of the main components used in the circuit. The processing speed increased from millisecond to microsecond. These computers required less power to run. Give three features of third generation computer. IC, integrated circuit. Technology makes the size of computer still smaller. The cost of computer reduced further. The capacity to hold data and information was more due to improved secondary storage. Devices. Give three features of fourth generation computers. These computers are for general purpose and widely used for commercial applications. Power consumption in these computers is very less. The languages like SQL, C, C++, Java, etc. were developed. Next question. Why is Charles Babbage known as the father of computer? Because modern computer follows the working principle of Charles Babbage's machine. Thank you students, thank you very much, and listen, all the question answers you have to write in your notebook. Thank you. God bless you.